What's up, guys? Corey here, coming at you with another episode of Carpet Time here on Carpet TV. Getting ready to put some carpet back together and then clean. I don't know how many rooms I'm going to clean, but that'll be on a different video anyway. So let me show you what I'm getting ready to put back together. This is pretty straightforward compared to some of the stuff I've been getting lately, so it almost looks like a day off. All right, I don't know exactly what happened here, but I'm going to put it all back together here. I guess there was two poles or something there. I'm not really sure. And then it's taken apart here. So I've got to put a little bit of carpet pad under that and then patch those two guys back in. And then this guy, I don't know what the story is with it, but it's got one side that looks almost decent. Not like what I'm looking for to put back together, but then I've got this other side here that's kind of messed up, so I'm gonna have to try to trim that up as much as I can and bring it back together and hopefully hide it. That's the goal. I don't know. I mean, I prefer to make my own cuts, but when you come across something like this, you've got to try to trim up what they have and put that back together, and it'll probably maybe involve the seam stretchers more than likely. I'll have to trim it off and then pull it back together and hide it like that. So anyway, I'm starting here. All right. When I trimmed it off, it come apart pretty far. So I mean, that's one side that I had to trim off, and now the other's over here. So it amounted to quite a bit, so I don't even know how you would do this if you didn't have these seam stretchers to pull it together. This one, it's not quite together yet, and this one is not quite together yet either. So, kind of stretch a little bit at a time. If you hold it here long enough, it'll relax, and it will kind of stay so you can back up your stretcher and stretch it again, get it closer. Whenever I finally get it to where I want it, I'm going to nail it all together and then seam it. But I don't know how I would do my job if it wasn't for these. If I had a third one, if I could find a third one for $150, I'd buy it too. I really like these guys. I don't know. I don't do install so much if I can get out of it, but as far as tricky repair that nobody else wants to mess with, that's where these guys come in handy. I don't think from an install standpoint, people use these. Anyway, back at it here. Check in a bit. All right. I've got it stretched back together here. And the more nails you put, the better off you are. The less nails you put, the more you will notice it try to pull back apart when you take the stretchers off. You would think one or two nails would do it, but they won't. It works better when you put one in front of the other rather than all across the side, because apparently the one in front of the other helps hold it in place a little better. So that is something to know, I guess, if anybody's interested in this particular method I developed, this high-tech nail through the carpet into the wood thing. It's fancy. All right, be back in a minute. All right. This guy is now back together. Can't see the seam. That's what I was looking for. I can see a little bit of it in the corner right over there. A little bit. But all of this is still got to be tucked back in. And I've got these guys sitting in here with tape underneath them, getting ready to be heated into place. So I got the irons. Looks like they're hot now. The lights are off, so gonna set my rags over all of these guys and steam them into place. and then tuck all of this back in. And then they want the just the hallway here and the stairs cleaned. So for that, I will just break out the Oreck because it's not that dirty and it's not that big. So I won't make a video on that though. That's just too little to mention. The work or the cleaning. So I'll probably do the vacuuming because there's a crowd that loves to see that. So there's all kind of mess needs to be vacuumed up here. So I'll cover that. All right, check this out. I got it all put back together. Get ready to start tucking everything back in. Realize there's no tack strip. Somebody ran the pad all the way to the damn wall. I was told to put that back together and do some patches. And now I'm gonna have to undo everything I did and probably start over again to put some tack strip in there. So, yay. All right, so I'll be here a little while longer, quite a bit. All right, now we're back together here. I didn't have to take my seam apart. I cut all the pad out. I took the nails out of the tack strip, I set it in place, and I used this guy to hold it to drive, put the little finishing nails in it. It's being held in the finishing nails all around. I put tack strip from there, all around there, around here, and over here. Some remodeler or something, like a little carpet trap set for me or something. Hold on. No more. All right, guys. Just like to show every part of this whole thing. You know, even when stuff gets overlooked, you can kind of see how this whole business works. A lot of guys like to put up their best work, the stuff they're most proud of, put it all up. Good, bad, victory, defeat, whatever. It's just how it works. It's tough. You get different situations all the time. And I, for some reason, overlooked and didn't check until it came time to tuck the carpet back in when I was finished. So I had to pull all my tools back out and go back to work again. All right, guys, thanks for watching. God bless. I'll see you in the next video.